Greetings from eMedi News and Heartcare Foundation of India. Welcome to our show, Chat with Dr. KK. Today we are going to have a chat with Dr. G.S. Senani, who is past president of Cardiological Society of India, past president of Association of Physicians of India, and past president of many other associations. No cardiology conference and a physicians conference is complete without his presence. Welcome to our show.
Thank you,
Dr. With your past experience in the field of cardiology, today we face an epidemic of coronary artery disease, blockages in the heart.
Yes.
Question is that we must detect it early enough, before it becomes symptomatic. And in that, there are many technologies. Some people talk about intima media thickness as a routine. But another thing which people, ultrasonologists, clinicians, and echocardiographers can do is to measure the flow-mediated dilatation of brachial artery. Today, we are going to focus on FMD.
Yes, doctor.
What is the importance of FMD in early diagnosis of coronary artery?
As you yourself said, that we want to detect these people at the earliest. And endothelial cell dysfunction is the earliest change occurs, is the bottom line, and then the atherosclerosis and things. So we should detect that. Now there have been invasive methods earlier, but now this non-invasive method, brachial artery, flow mediated artery, by using the ultrasonography machine, is very safe and is non-radiologic, no exposure, and cost effective. We have done two major studies. We have studied 100 cases of hypertension at the early, and we found that hypertension has got significant endothelial cell dysfunction as much as the coronary artery disease. And if we can screen these patients of hypertension, or even the children of the hypertension, or even children who have got risk factors like obesity and this, and check it, then we can even advise the children from adolescence. There are papers that you should advise them from adolescence that these are the children who are at risk to go for pre-hypertension, hypertension, coronary artery disease and all complications.
So is this test reproducible?
Yes, it is reproducible,
so
but I must...
If you take a puff of cigarette...
I must admit that we in India still do not have that much experience. Only there are a few papers. One came from Ravi Kasliwal, and that and this is our second study which we are doing it. We have done two studies. It needs more experience for our country. And once it is, I actually have even proposed it that we should use this in a health checkup, because this can earlier executives coming in health checkup, we can tell them that look, your stress test is negative, but your endothelial cell dysfunction.
Okay. What is the standard protocol you are following? Is it 5 minutes of occlusion?
Yes, 5 minutes.
And then for, then 1 minute.
Then we release it, and with the release there is a NO release, and then you get
dilatation
and
so
all
and
that.
The criteria you're using is dilatation and velocity, both are only dilatation?
Dilatation mainly, and also velocity integrals also. Indeed. We are.
And what about the symptoms? If the person says, I'm getting pain, and
we usually say there should be 5 minutes, but if the patient is not able to tolerate that much of pressure, then we make it even 4 minutes, 3 and a half.
No, I'm saying something different. People who experience pain invariably will have no endothelial dysfunction, and those people who are not experiencing pain at all, can that be a criteria to diagnose apart from your dilatation?
No, this point we are really not studied, that with those who,
because
are
what my observations in my patients are, that people who tolerate 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 7 minutes without any pain, without any discomfort, are the ones who have endothelial dysfunction.
Achcha.
And people who have pain, they invariably will have a good dilatation.
No, this we have not observed, I must say that. We will observe in our future.
Okay. Now once we do a flow mediated dilatation, and the criteria using is 10%, 20%.
10%.
So less than 10% is abnormal, more than 10% is normal.
Yes.
Now you have a person who is less than 10%.
Yes.
Now diagnosis is over, he has endothelial dysfunction.
Yes.
Intima media thickness is normal.
Yeah.
And then I may or may not do the velocity test.
Right.
The aorta brachial velocity. And suppose I find a patient comes to me with endothelial dysfunction, that means he is FMD less than, say it is 5% or 6%.
Yes, actually.
How do I treat?
No, we have found, this is one level which you said, that those who have got less than 5.4%, they definitely have coronary artery disease, because we have, in all cases who had coronary artery disease, it was, and this has been also reported by Bhargava et al. Also,
so less than 5.4%
definite coronary artery disease.
If it is zero,
more
minus,
than 10 normal, and in between there can be a
if
variable.
If it is zero, severe disease?
Is there no, very, very severe disease. We have not found that zero. To
in some cases, the artery constrict instead of dilatation.
Well, that again, I don't have much experience.
Okay, now which drug to use? Is it only lifestyle, stop smoking?
No, of course, everything, right from the lifestyle and everything, and then depends upon symptoms. First, we have to say diet, lifestyle, reducing weight, stop smoking and all that, what we know it, coronary risk factors. And then see how the patient goes. You can again repeat it after 3 months.
If a drug has to be used, what is the drug of choice in these cases? Is it nifedipine, amlodipine, or any other? ACE inhibitor?
Well, here...
Is there any study which talks about drug reversibility of endothelial dysfunction?
No, so there's all these patients, drugs...
When I talk to the nephrologist, they say ACE inhibitors improves endothelial dysfunction.
Yes,
it also improve FMD.
Yes, I agree with you. The ACE inhibitor is one of the important, and ARBs also, you know, they also help in reversing that. These drugs, but again, I must say, I do not have personal experience of doing in a human study. But as per the theoretical literature, ACE inhibitors are good.
So we should be able to repeat the test how often?
Well, you can repeat it after 3 months, 6 months and see while he's on ACE inhibitor whether we have succeeded in reducing it. As such, as you know, ACE inhibitors are given in cases of, say, myocardial infarction, post-myocardial infarction, from that point of view also.
Okay. Anything else in inflammatory dilatation?
No, this same thing, we did it also in diabetes, and in diabetes also we found that diabetes is a coronary artery equivalent. They have got almost, so we have proved
so
that
point. I come back to something different in the same field. There is there are lots of studies which talks about remote preconditioning of the heart. What they have done is, they have done the same flow mediated dilatation, not as a diagnostic, but as a therapeutic.
Okay.
What they do is, they compress the artery, they compress the brachial artery for 5 minutes and then release it for a minute, then again compress it for 5 minutes, then release it for not 1 minute, 5 minutes. Five minute compression, 5 minute release. 5 minute compression, 5 minute release. So dilatation is because of nitrous oxide.
Yes.
And they have seen when this nitrous oxide is released, it is released throughout the body, not only here.
So
it will cause dilatation not only of brachial artery, but it may cause dilatation of renal artery.
Yes.
People are saying
that NO can help the other.
So what they are saying is that if you are going for a creatinine of 1.5, 1.6, and if you are going for an angio to prevent contrast nephropathy, you can use this FMD technique as a therapeutic condition.
I agree what you say, there is a sense in that, I agree. This is
called remote preconditioning, which you can use to prevent reperfusion injury.
This is good point, though. Again, I do not have personal experience, but this is what
we do
it
as a routine in all patients with compromised renal function. If they're going for angio, we do it half an hour before and do it four or five times.
Yes.
We don't have a comparative data, but
this is wonderful. I would say this is wonderful. I get a cue from you. I get a point for you.
Coming away from the academics, what are your hobbies?
My hobbies. Singing.
Singing?
Yeah.
I don't think so my audience will believe you unless you sing. Let's face the audience. Let's face the audience and sing two lines.
Chaudhvi ka chand ho, ya aftab ho, jo bhi ho tum khuda ki kasam, la jawab ho. Chaudhvi ka chand ho, zulfe hai jaise kaandon pe badal jhuke hue, aankhein hai jaise mai ke pyaale bhare hue, masti hai jisme pyaar ki tum wo sharab ho. Chaudhvi ka chand ho ya aftab ho, jo bhi ho tum khuda ki kasam, la jawab ho.
Chaudhvi ka chand kaun hai zindagi
mein? Maybe I can tell that it is my wife, but it is just imagine. I didn't sing that well. I sing much better than this.
Okay.
This is
so you are, that means if you would not have been a doctor, at least you would have had one more profession as a singer.
No, not that. No. It is a hobby. But I sing better than this. I sing in conferences.
Very good.
I sing bhajans in mandir and all that, you know, I sing.
Very good. And that's the reason you're keeping
yes,
fit. Yes,
every Sunday when my wife goes to a temple.
We know that every sound produces a chemical in the body and is
yes,
a healer.
Yes.
People who sing.
You see, we have every Sunday a session that person, our Guruji comes. And not only I sing, but even, you know, my daughter-in-law's, my son and all that, we all sing. It's a group sort of thing. And
Governor of Maharashtra calls you. And ask you to implement one policy in cardiovascular, gives you full powers, what will you do?
Prevention.
In what? In prevention what? One line.
Prevention.
Exercise or what?
Exercise.
So you
because
will make
see,
sure that...
See, I ask many people, my patients, they say, I don't get time. And I give them example of Anil Ambani. He jogs 11 kilometers daily. I walk 5 kilometers daily. I meet him in Marine Drive. I say, if Anil Ambani, who is such a busy man, gets it, you don't get it. I think exercise has got 15 qualities which no drug has got it. Exercise. Of course, diet comes, smoking.
Obviously, but if it is one, then
one,
exercise.
One, I would put exercise because people are very lazy. They don't exercise in our country.
My last thing, that for preventing sudden cardiac arrest from sudden cardiac arrest, public must be taught hands-only CPR.
Oh yes, that should be actually, we are taught in our Jaslok Hospital, everybody. Our lift man, or this is everybody, even residents and all that, everybody.
Will you appoint anybody in a hospital setting unless he has learned CPR?
Will you appoint?
Chowkidar, reward boy.
No, we those who are already employed, we have taught them because our new CEO came.
New people who are joining, they must
yes,
learn and come.
They must learn, yes. I agree with you.
In our chat, we have come to know that his hospital in the country is one hospital where it is impossible to work unless you have learned
hands-on
CPR. Jaslok Hospital. In Jaslok Hospital, everybody, whether you are a chowkidar or a ward boy or a healthcare provider, you have to learn chest compression CPR. So we thank our guest, Dr. Senani, for being
okay.
with us.
And, thank you, KK. We are all good old friends.
Beautiful lines of his song. And hopefully his wife will also listen to it, that this song was devoted to her. That's all for today. We'll come back with one more show. Till that, goodbye. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.